neuromuscular junction. It's the place where the motor axons release acetylcholine. So objects that are moving rather sideways are going to appear in progressively different positions as you go deeper into the data set. Look at it for any one of a number of questions. Box of brain. And once you've done that, then you can turn into wiring diagrams. And the way we do this, or we began doing this, is by hand. Andy Berger made a coloring book. It's a program called VAST, which is really wonderful to use. It's a digital coloring book, basically. When you find an object that you find interesting, it's a dendrite, you color it in section after section. So it's good. You can see everything. And if you go back to the axon here, a cross section of this three-dimensional object here against that dendrite. Of course, you don't want to just do two objects. You want to now this is everything. Now this took months of effort. It was slightly larger volume, and the focus of this was simply to ask, but this is everything. And there's a lot of things. I was going to say shitload, but I don't want to use it. A lot of stuff. And we went through and itemized every single one of these objects. You can categorize them very straightforwardly into things that are axons and things that I did into ones that are myelinated and ones that are inhibitory and excitatory. The oligodendrocytes were in there as well as astrocytes. Embarrassingly, a bunch of things that we still don't know what they are. And that's because even though we crumble, we just zoom up, but the whole thing looks just like that area. Every single wire is segmented. This is a blood vessel. We didn't train it well on blood vessels, so you see a little dodgy stuff there. We'll fix that, but that's irrelevant for the wiring diagram. So at this point now, you have basically the whole wiring diagram, and here's a neuron, and a glial cell, and another neuron, the budding against it. So here is that data set, and now we can basically do brainwave, basically, without transgenics. I can just flip on any one of these cells and generate a three-dimensional version of whatever cell I click on. So I'm just going to show you these arbitrary cells. This little orange cell, this cell is that yellow cell in that last image. And I'm just, this is a minuscule portion of what's in this volume. But each of those cells, if I go back a second, each of those cells are just seeing one section there. Now this is a full three-dimensional reconstruction, including every dendritic spot.